Okay, so everybody can see my screen. All right, guys, I would be your Tableau trainer. I am Akriti. I have totally 8 years of experience in different industry verticals, and I have 4 years of experience in Tableau. So I have designed multiple Tableau visualizations for different industries. Since it's a demo session, I'll just tell you exactly what Tableau is and what are the products of Tableau. And last maybe few minutes we'll spend in just getting excited with Tableau. So quickly we'll see what all the chart types we can make and how is Tableau going to help us in the visualization. So we'll start with Tableau introduction. Now, why did the need of Tableau actually arise? You know, because initially the reporting was basically done on Excel or maybe some other reporting tools which most of the companies were following. But all of a sudden, since Tableau came into market, and it's been proved very effective. Now, why did the need of Tableau or faster visual analytics come into picture? Because it's all because in 2020, the world's data is expected to reach around 45 zettabytes. So zettabyte is really a huge data that has been, flowing in. And as I would expect everybody of you to keep yourself on mute so that we can have a smooth session ahead. And if in case anybody wants to say something, they can put it in chat window or ask me to ask me before you unmute yourself so that everybody is on the same platform. Okay, thank you for that. And like I was saying that nowadays our lots of data is being stored. Even if we talk about individual ourselves, right from ordering pizza to credit card, all the data are stored with our phone numbers. You know, the first time you go to any hospital or go IBGO or your normal Domino's also, they just store your data. And until and unless that data is brought into use, it's of no, just keeping it makes no sense. You need to bring some value out of that data. And when you want to bring out value from that data in a faster way so that you can analyze it properly, you need to have a fast visual reporting tool. So that is the reason Tableau is helping people to do exactly that. So what exactly is Tableau? Tableau software is an American computer software company where its headquarters is in Seattle, USA. It produces a family of interactive data visualization products focused on business intelligence. So Tableau has got lots of, it's got a huge product family. So basically there are five products that Tableau has. So it starting from Tableau Desktop, where again you have two types of desktop: personal version, professional version. You have a Tableau Public, you have Tableau Server, Tableau Online, and Tableau Reader. So these basically are the five product families of Tableau. We'll deal with them individually. So this is what I was talking about, right? If you can see that in 2008, it was the data which we had was really very minor or very less, and this is what we are expecting. So right now we are over here, right, a lot of data. So you can see a 1 zettabyte data is like 1 billion terabytes. So if I talk about 45 zettabytes, it's like huge data. So when you have so much data, you need a faster analysis. So what exactly is Tableau? Tableau is a business intelligence software that allows anyone to easily connect to data, then visualize and create interactive shareable dashboards. So, when you are working with Tableau, the best way to present your data to the client or even to the final presentation of the data is best in a dashboard. Yes, you have an option of building stories also, but stories has not yet gained much familiarity in Tableau world. Many people are not very familiar with stories in Tableau, but it's not a bad idea. I always do my presentation in stories. So we'll deal with how do you develop a story. But yes, dashboard is a great way of presenting your visualization. When you try to present your visualization and per worksheet level, it doesn't look good. And plus all the manipulations of with your data is there on the data pane and it's visible. So it looks a little unorganized when you present it. So the best way is to present it on a dashboard. And when we will be heading to this, we will see how we can present different types of dashboards. Moving ahead with what Tableau is, it is easy enough that even a non-technical users can learn it, but powerful enough to satisfy even the most complex analytical problems. So it's quite easy, you know. You can just, if you happen to work with Tableau, you feel that you just drag and drop a few data panes into the worksheet canvas and something appears. So it's quite easy, but here I differ in a way because, you know, why do I differ is when you do data analysis or when you're working with data, you have two important ingredients. You have one is your question and one is the data with which you need to derive your answers from. So basically, you would not just require, you know, anything. Just any visualization to pop up in your screen and you're comfortable with this. With each data set comes a question that you need to answer to. So basically, I believe yes, Tableau is quite easy, but we should tame Tableau in such a way that it gives us what we want. You know, it's not that we have the choice of show me option and there are some charts and it tells me, okay, these are the charts which you can make through show me. And that is all you can do. No, there are various other charts that are not present in Show Me. And you can, of course, make so many different types of chart. So through the training, we will also see how to bring the Show Me option into minimum use and build different types of chart, which will make us stand apart from those who are using normal Show Me options. Okay, moving ahead. Securely sharing your finding with others only takes seconds. So naturally uploading your Tableau visualization to Tableau server, or even if your company doesn't have a Tableau server, they can go for Tableau online. And you know, even print screen and sending workbooks as an attachment is a very handy thing in Tableau world. It doesn't matter if we send a print screen attached in a mail. It is quite a quite normal thing to do. So it is not very complicated that each time you have to upload a particular visualization into the server. Actually, you only upload those visualizations which you are confident with and you are like end to end done with the workbook. Then only you go and upload it on the server, because server is a little complicated thing. You can't just go on putting anything and everything on the server. It has a limited space and lots of users are there. You cannot just confuse them with any analysis that you have done. So you have to be sure of what you're putting on server. But again, when you're working so much and hard in building a visualization, you would always want, and you reach to analysis, you would always want to share it across the team, or maybe share it with your client. In that case, you can just send as an attachment in your mail through a print screen or a Word doc. So all these things are quite acceptable. It's not like you would be seen as a very kiddish thing to do. It's quite acceptable in Tableau world. So we'll see which other ways you can share your Tableau visualization and moving ahead with the training. Tableau is a BI software that you can trust to actually deliver answer to people that need them. Yes, you will get a crisp answer, but again, you should know how to handle Tableau with. There are cases when Tableau will draw you nuts, like, okay, this is not what I want, or this is so simple and Tableau is not able to do it. It's not like that. Yes, there are some limitations of Tableau, but with each limitation, there are workarounds. So it is quite easy to get your answers through Tableau. Okay, now when we say that Tableau is for visual analytics, so what exactly is visual analytics? Visual analytics is the representation and presentation of data that exploits your visual perceptions, abilities in order to amplify cognitions. So just to amplify your understanding, you have to build your, you have to do a visual analytics. So moving ahead, if I ask you in just 10 seconds that how many number of 9 is there, can anybody guess it? And please remember that you have just 10 seconds. Do I get answer from anybody in the chat window? No? Oh, at least you should have tried. Anybody? So your 10 seconds already over. Well, if I ask you now, if how many 9 is there, and it's just hung up, so let me just try it out. And why is my system hung? Oops. Oh. Right, so if I ask you now, how many 9, so can I get the answer in 10 seconds? Somebody can put it in the chat window. 12? 10? Okay, so at least you tried. So I think it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes, so 10 is the right answer. So like you can see, it is tough when you have just blank data to analyze from, and with little color, I've just put on few numbers, how easy it becomes to analyze things. So this is what is your visual analytics, you know. When you have loads and loads of data and you have to sit and analyze those, it becomes little complicated to do it. But when you have just added little colors to it, it becomes little much easier to analyze it from just your blank data. You know, so it is just said that human perception is like, if I ask you to do this mental maths, you know, until analyst you that bang on in mental maths, it would be tough. But if I ask you to do it on pen and paper, it would be quite easy for you. So it is stated that if mental maths takes around 50 seconds, a pen and paper may just take around 10 or 20 seconds to do it. So given a representation, a graphical representation to the data, the analysis becomes quite faster. So, you know, if I just have a normal, I understand that you don't have a data understanding, you don't know what exactly the data is. But if I ask you which is the subcategory that is giving the least sales, I think you will be able to tell me, right? Is it tables? Yes, because it's all in negative and it is, you know, colored red, showing a negative value in a pinpoint. So you know, the way I put Tableau visualization is you should have a 80-20 relationship in your, when you try to build a Tableau visualization. So what exactly is 80-20 relationship? That in first 20 seconds when anybody looks at your Tableau visualization, they should come to know 80% of your data or exactly your analysis of what you are trying to figure out, right? So if I just ask you this visualization, it's a Tableau visualization, that what exactly it is. So in 20 seconds, you will tell me that this is showing me a profit of category and subcategory in which tables is doing bad. And it is really doing bad. So I think nobody will disagree with this, right? So in 20 seconds, you are at least able to make out 80% of the data. So that crisp is how your Tableau visualization should look, and not any drag and drop that Tableau has automatically thrown in front of you. So basically, you should be aware of what you are asking Tableau to build. So again, the same visualization is presented in a bar graph, and now you may even be able to point out that which is the best selling category right? So roughly I think copiers are is the best. Yes, right, copiers is the best. And the worst is, the worst is tables, right? Guys, a small request from my side is, this training of mine is going to be entirely an interactive. Even if you guys are on mute, you can always put things in chat, and it's going to be entirely a hands-on training, right? So it's not going to be a normal thing where I just do the whole of the talking and you need to sit. So you can always put things in chat. I don't mind. Okay. So moving ahead, this is the cycle of visual analytics. So basically you have, So you have a task, you get a data, you find the structure, as in what exactly you need and how is the data formatted. Then you view the data, you develop an insight, and you act. So this whole circle goes on and on. So it's a kind of a scrum, guys. So if you are aware of this the football match, you know what happens in football match? They don't decide things in advance. They just come together, decide the way they are going to achieve the second goal, and then they head for it. And even Scrum certification is quite a hot thing going on in the market these days. Lots of professionals are going for Scrum certification. So it's basically a kind of thing that, depending upon your company's norms, you decide, or either on a daily basis or on a weekly basis or on every Friday, you decide the goal of the next week, that how are you going to plan things ahead. And then you do the development for 1 week, then you sit for a meeting and you do the analysis. The whole the team does the analysis. Okay, this is what we have achieved. If that is what they were looking for and they are quite close, they go on to level 2. If that's not what they are looking for, then they see that where are they going to lag, where they are actually lagging, and they take those things into consideration when they go for level 2 development. So that's how things move. Things are moving nowadays in software world. And because after each step of your development, your analysis sits hand in hand, the reason of faster analysis has come into picture, because you need to have analysis faster so that you can move on to level 2. But earlier, they were following a waterfall method where they had, you know, business on top and developers below, the whole hierarchy of people sitting down, and the developers didn't have any knowledge about the business. The business didn't have any knowledge about the development, and there was a huge gap in middle of the development that was taking place, and it was not easy, you know. So with Scrum and faster analysis, lots of things have become quite easy. So again, the visuals best practices are, you should always remember that you are representing the data for humans. So it should be very simple. It should not be complex. And even if you are building complex visualizations, which we would move ahead and I would show you how to build complex visualizations also. But again, those complex visualizations should have at least proper anecdotes and captions in your workbook, so that it is easy for any normal human being to analyze it. You should use ample colors, but again, you please keep it in mind that when you are working with Tableau, it gives you a variety of colors to use from. You know, Tableau's got a huge color range, but it is always advisable to make a particular color your habit. You know, if moving ahead, you will notice that I have a habit of always showing my. You have a habit of, you know, I have a habit of always depicting my profit with green and my loss with red. So anybody who is working with me, or even if he is not working with me and he happens to see my series of workbooks, by just 2-3 visualization, he will come to know, okay, this lady, she just shows her profit with green and losses with red, and it is it's quite easy for you to analyze it. So even if when you have a whole range of colors to use from, please try to select the best that suits you, and it is always easy to use a color, a similar color range for your entire workbook. Now that's very easy. Whenever you are using a entire workbook, your entire workbook is a kind of the multiple worksheets that are having your analysis. Okay, so the workbook should always follow the same color pattern. The different worksheets should have the same color pattern. If you are showing sales as blue in one sheet, the sales should be in blue in all the sheets. If you are showing your quantity as brown in one worksheet, it should be brown in all the other, rather than just changing the color in each worksheet. Maps, you can use a lot of maps when you are developing your visualization for a particular state. It is always advisable that when you are dealing with states, do it through maps. And then finally you present it through creating a dashboard. So that's the basics of Tableau. Now let me just show you one Excel, which maybe I will forward you moving ahead in the training. But before that, like I said, there are various product families of Tableau. So quickly I'll show you some. So this is Tableau Public. Now Tableau Public is a free edition. I'll deal with each of the product families individually in when we are having a detailed class. I'm just giving you a quick glimpse of how each product looks, and maybe because Tableau Public is free, I don't know how you guys are moving ahead with training. So can you just tell me quickly, like, which product will you use for your training? How many of you are having that public desktop? Is anybody having a public desktop to work with? If you are not having a public desktop license version to work with, you can always download Tableau Public. Tableau Public is free for it's like free, and it has 10 GB of space to use, and 10 GB is a lot of space. In case you need extra space, you just have to use another credentials to credentials to log in. And so like I was saying, you can all of you can just download Tableau Public, and we can work in Tableau Public. It's just that it is free and the confidentiality of data is not there, so you can just work on sample data. Okay, because anybody can log in and they can download your workbook, and along with the workbook you have the data attached, so you can always use a Tableau Public for the training purpose. So this was Tableau Public. This is Tableau Reader. It doesn't have any data connectivity. Only the thing is, you can open your visualization that is sent as a package workbook. So again, we'll have a detailed description of this. And this is your Tableau Desktop. Okay. So again, Tableau Desktop has two bifurcations. One is a personal version, one is the professional version. So this is professional version. Okay, the difference is you have a huge list of data connectivity in the professional version. The personal version has a limited data connectivity. Again, when we'll deal with detail, I'll just show you the difference. So we can, and yes, if you will ask me what is the exact difference between personal and professional, a professional and the public version, is the data connectivity. Like you can see, I have a huge data connectivity. The public comes with a very limited data connectivity, right? And when I do any development on my desktop version, I can store it in my system. But if you are planning to take the training on Tableau Public, you need to have a Tableau Public account, and each time when you will when you will close your workbook, you have to either destroy your creation or put it on Tableau Public. So that's not going to be much problem, you know, because I have taken training on Tableau Public and it's absolutely fine. So it's, you can go ahead and download Tableau Public, and you can download Tableau Public 10.2 because that's in the market. Yes, you can practice in Tableau Public. You can just, because all the data sets that I would be sharing you for the training, you can open it on Tableau Public, and I don't have an issue with the confidentiality of the data. So any visualization that you prepare, you can just post it on Tableau Public. So that's absolutely fine. Okay. So, and this is Tableau Reader. Usually Tableau Reader is free, and you can only open your visualizations and check the visualization, like how it looks. And Tableau Reader is basically with the CEOs and the final clients who don't want to make much changes to the visualization, but they just want to open your visualization and see it. So Tableau Reader is also free. You can also download that and keep it in your system, you know, because you now and then you would want to open your visualization on the reader and see how the client will get the look and feel of the data. So if I just quickly open it and show it to you. So it takes little time to open up. Right, so like you can see the entire workbook that I have uploaded on Tableau Public, as a package workbook, is opened on Tableau Reader, and it is as it is except with the data that is there. So even if I look at the worksheets, now these are the worksheets, it doesn't have the data pane, right? Nor does it have an option to view the data. So I'm just right clicking on this, and you can see that I'm not getting an option of view data or anything like that. So I can't make any changes over here, but any filters or parameters that I add to this works fine. Okay, so maybe I can just go over here and show it to you. Right, so you can see all the parameters and all the filters are working fine, the visualization is changing and all those things are happening. It's just that I'm unable to see the data behind. This is Reader, okay, and Public and Desktop I have already told you. Right, so this is the basic visualization that I will be sharing. This is the basic Excel that we will be working on, and we would be doing hands-on on this. So this is a normal sample Superstore Excel. Guys, you know what? When you will be downloading your Tableau Public, in your documents folder, you will notice you have a folder in your documents folder. You have a folder as Tableau Repository, and that Tableau Repository has just a second here, I have a question. Which type of Tableau does organizations use? Usually the companies will give you professional version of Tableau Desktop, which is this. Until analyst, they are, you know, if it's a startup and they feel that there are very limited data sources that they will work with, they may give you a personal version of Desktop, but usually they give you professional version, which comes with all these data sources, and it looks like this. So any visualization that you do, you have it on the screen. The recent visualizations, you have it on screen, and like I was talking about the drive. So let me just, you know, take you to right. So in your documents folder, you have my Tableau Repository, And this in Tableau repository, you have a whole series of workbooks that, you have a whole series of folders that Tableau has automatically set up for you, right? So what happens is, in these folders, they have a path defined. So if I store anything, in a particular folder, I'm able to locate it directly without much issue. Okay, so like I was talking about, this is the Excel. Is there any issue with my screen? Can all of you see my screen? Okay, so moving ahead, this is a Excel, this is my business Excel. Okay, so this basically my orders has talks about everything about my business. Okay, it has a row ID, order ID, order date, ship mode, the customers, the segment, the country, etc. And so I'll just quickly scroll it and I'll show you. So it's like not that big, it is around 9,994 rows. Okay, and this sheet in Excel talks about the entire business. So which are the categories, the state, the city, the postal code, the region, the product ID, the product name, category, subcategory, so a whole list. All right, the second tab talks about the returns, so basically the order ID and whether it is returned or not. And the third talks about few people and they are coming from which region. So maybe it's just a my managers from different region. So it is a huge Excel. Now I don't know anything about the business, and this is the data for me. Anything that development that I want to do ahead for the business, I have to do it on this Excel. Okay, so you just quickly we'll see how easy it is to analyze it through Tableau. Yes, if you're an Excel person and you know the formulas well, you can just put in few filters and few formulas. I'm not saying it's tough, but at times it may be tough when you need to add VLOOKUP and LLOOKUP and all those things, right? So we'll not go into that complex VLOOKUP, LLOOKUP thing. I'll just quickly connect my Tableau to Excel. So this is my Tableau desktop. I'm just connecting it to Excel. So I have my Excel over here. And you know, I don't have to go on and search it there, because once you have, once you are storing everything in your Tableau repository under particular folders, Tableau, or even if there is, you know, a particular folder in which each time you are storing your data set, it is easy, the Tableau identifies that path very easy after you have used it multiple times. So just if we drag the order sheet, which was the first main sheet for us in this Excel, right? So this is the main sheet. It has a whole list of the business that we are doing. So it is like quickly I scroll it down and I can see it has got 9,995. That is one being the header. It has 9,994 rows, right? So I have just connected my Excel to this. And Tableau tells me whether I'm connected live or extract. So we will deal with all these individually. So what if, how will this place look when you are connected to a server? How will this place look when you are connected to an Excel or a CSV file? So we'll have multiple hands-on on this, right? Right now, I'm just seeing that I've just connected it, and through clicks, my whole of the Excel has been imported to my Tableau. And just without writing formulas, my Excel sheet is not visible. Okay. So let's skip that for now. It's we can just see that. So you can see my Tableau, right? You can see the screen. So I have a one yes and one no. So who said no? Maybe you have to check. Ramkrishnan, I think just check any issue from your side, because Manoj can see my screen and Nageshwar can also see my screen. So I think maybe Excel I have not shared, so it's okay. But can you see my Tableau? Just check it from your side. Okay, just check and let me know. So to all those who can see my screen, if I just ask you that, okay, which are the states that we are doing our business in? So if you happen to look at Excel, it has got a whole list of state, and just to identify individual states, we have it'll take time. For as for Tableau, we just need to go there on state and just double click it, and we have the whole list of state. Now you say that I'm, you know, personally, if I talk about myself, Tableau One workbook, and it has not been able to see. You're not able to see after the, you're not able to see a map in front of you. No. Can I just quickly check it, because this thing is also okay. How about now? Okay. So we have, everybody can see it. Okay, so everybody can see it. So so let's take it back. Like I was saying, that the Excel has a whole list of state that we are performing in. Now if I ask you which are the states, you know, you just go to Excel and we analyze it. But from Tableau, if I just, you know, double click on my state, I have it in front of me. And if I talk personally about myself, I'm not that very great at maps, you know. I can't look and identify about the place. Two things: you just hover and you come to know about the state. So even if you don't add anything, you can see it in front of you, that okay, these are the states that I'm performing in. Or you can just drag the states to labels. So right now, don't worry about all these things. We will be dealing in detail each of these. So there's nothing in Tableau that will be left untouched from my side, and after the training gets over, there would be nothing that you know, you hear in Tableau and you will say that, oh, I don't know this. So we will cover everything in detail, right from the data mapping and how do we pull in data, to what our data pane is, how are these fields coming, what if I want to change any of these. So everything in detail we'll go on. Okay, I'm just like right now just showing you how easy it is to work with Tableau. And if I ask you about total sales, so maybe just drop sales into colors, and I have it in front of me. So the darker the shade, this scale is telling me about the sales. So the darker the value, the maximum is the sales, lighter the value, less is the sales. Okay, so I have it in front of me that California is really doing good, Texas is doing bad, because you know, it's got less sales, and maybe these areas are further bad. This is California is doing good, Texas second, or maybe third, and this is second, and Washington. So basically four states that are really doing good are these. Okay, moving ahead, if I just talk about, okay, just tell me which are the categories and subcategories I'm selling, because that is the most important thing for me in Tableau, in my visualization, in my business. So I have category over here. I just double click. I come to know that these are the three basic categories that I deal with. Under these are the segments that I'm dealing with. Okay, and under each segment, these are the various subcategories that I have. So just to give it to you in text, I have this. Okay, or maybe if you want to arrange it in this manner. So you have consumers, corporates and home offices. Under these three, you again have three bifurcations of furniture, office supplies and technology, and each category has further subdivisions of subcategories. If I ask about the sales that each one of them is making, I just drop it into the visualization and I have it in front of me. If I again want to analyze it in profit and loss, I can further do it by adding colors to the sales, and it will give me a range to choose from. So, you know, chairs is really doing good over here. Binders is really doing good. Again, this is doing good. This is doing good. So, can you tell me about office supplies? Do I have any answer? Anybody who wants to answer for office supplies? No? Nobody? Okay, so maybe in office supplies, storage is doing best. And I'm not analyzing the figures, guys. I'm just looking at the color range and I'm telling you. Here, darker the shade, darker the value and stuff like that. Okay? So maybe if I am not comfortable with blue and I want to give it some different color range, so I can give it a red color range. Well, I don't personally prefer red for sales because red and green are basically for profit and loss. So I can change it. So quite easy, right? If I want to show it in just a graph, I can do that also. So I just drag this and sales over here. Maybe I want to give it some nice, not a simple bar graph. I want to make it a little complicated so I can, or maybe something different which nobody else makes. So I can just make it a dual axis and quickly I can just go here and oops, my right click is not working. Okay, it's taking time. So I'll just close it. And from here, so I will tell you exactly what we are doing right now. Just concentrate on that. I just don't want to show it in normal bar graph, so we can just, you know, make this as a lollipop chart and give it. So just presenting it as a normal bar graph or presenting it in a lollipop chart is. Now this will, you know, if somebody, your manager or a higher management, or even if your client looks, this is nice, it looks nice, you know, when it is represented in a different color, and maybe we can just color the head, the circles in a different color showing the different sales, and along with this put sales in labels to give it figures. So these are the things which we can quickly do, or maybe moving ahead. If I just ask you which are, I am not concerned about states, you know, I'm not concerned about values, you know. I don't want to see the values of each subcategories, that is values of sales. I don't want to see the sales value of the subcategories, but I just want to know that which subcategory is making my, giving me the maximum sales. So, and I don't want the values. So all I need to do is just drop it in text and the sale goes into the size, and from here I'll change it to text again, and I have it. So you know, my envelopes, arts, fastener is really doing really bad, whereas all these which are, you know, bigger and very prominent on face of it, maximum being the phones, so I don't have to concentrate on values and I have it there on the face. Let me just drop colors also, so that will make much better visualization. So I'm not concentrating on the sales value, the individual sales value, but overall structure I'm able to find out, right? So I really need to improve on my fasteners and labels and art, whereas all the rest and also envelopes if I want, while all the rest are fine. So you can see how easy it is to build visualization in Tableau. And each time till now, if you would have noticed that I have not opened these options, these show me options, show me chart types that are quite prominent on the face of Tableau. And anybody who has not had a detailed analysis and a detailed knowledge of Tableau, the first thing what we do is we open a show me button and we try to build a visualization from here. I have been also doing it in my initial stages, but right now, but after so much analysis and time that I have spent with Tableau, I don't feel like opening show me button. But yes, again, I'm not overruling it that I don't use it. Of course, yes, I use it. And like you can see if I just want to, you know, show quickly an analysis of how much sales and my profit per subcategory, I just take my subcategory, I take my sales, and I take my profit, shift to analytics tab, drag a reference line, of course, there, and I will do it on sum of profit, and because I have used sum, I'll just choose this, and okay. So my sales is this much and my profit is this much. It is there on my tooltip also. And again, I can do a little bit formatting it, arrange it in a proper manner. But even if I don't arrange it, it's there. So you can see, as for bookcases, my sales is quite good, whereas this, I'm suffering a loss. Here also, I'm suffering a loss with supplies, with tables, I'm suffering a loss. Partners, I am on the margin. I am very much on the margin, you know, and I'm not doing that great. So a correlation is also very, very easy without using the show me button. I just need to know that what each field will do and what is the exact definition for each of these, and how are these going to help me to present a visualization. I don't need to use the automated features of Tableau. So that's how easy it is to you know, work with Tableau. Moving ahead, guys, with we would like to move ahead with the hands-on session. And initially, your first class is only going to be the little introduction and know-how of what Tableau is and what are the pages, the data sources that you can connect to, and what does your data source canvas looks like, and what does each of the sheet look like. After that, the entire session is going to be hands-on. So the way I would take your session would be, I would explain you the concept, I will show you one hands-on, and I'll throw up a question to you in front of you so that we can pause for 2-3 minutes and quickly see if anybody is having any issue in building that particular chart type, or any question that I have given you, as in workbooks and as in calculated fields and table calculations and all those. You are going to have a recorded session, so after that, you know, you can just, when I'm doing a hands-on, you can concentrate on what I am doing and maybe take down notes if you want of how I went on, and then try it later. If you have any issues, you can reach out to me through me. Okay, so that's how we would take up any question for you guys. I'll just stop the session over here. I have 5 minutes. Quickly, if there are any questions or anything that you want me to answer, just put it on chat window and I'll answer it. Okay, thank you, Manoj. Anybody else who wants to answer anything? Or who wants me to answer anything? Yes, just to ask you, like anybody who's planning to go for certification here, Tableau certification? Okay, thank you, Grisha. Okay, Manil, so you're thinking of it. So, you know, during the training, I may also tell you the topics which do come in certification and have to come in certification. Along with that, I would be giving you assignments which will help you in, you know, planning for your certifications, kind of questions come in certification. So you can have a hands-on of the that, but that would be after I have completed 60% of the course. Anybody else? Okay, thank you. Okay, guys, can we do one thing? Can we just put ourselves on unmute ourselves rather one by one and. I'm so sorry. Can we just have a quick introduction from your side? This part we missed. I missed earlier. So can we have a quick introduction? Not missed. I just felt off. Like let's start with the session. So can we just have a quick introduction from your side? Like what are your expectations from the course so that I can keep that in mind while taking up the session? Can one by one all of you unmute yourself and take this up?
Yeah. Hi, Kriti. Hi, everyone. This is Manoj. I have done my master's in Wilmington University in Information Assurance, which is called MIS. And back in India, I worked almost for 1.5 year in GE Capital for a banking process, which is credit cards. And right now, I'm expecting the training from Tableau. Just like you said, it's an interactive session, and I'm thinking about the certification. So I'm just curious, like what kind of questions and how would the certification be, and is it mandatory to be certified, or like is there any benefit if you get certified on this for the job weightage for your resume? Yeah, that's the only question I have.
Okay, thanks, Manoj. Actually, it is not very mandatory, but because Tableau certification is little complicated and little tough to achieve, it does carry a lot of weightage, but again it's your choice. I mean, so we can during a session sometime middle in the middle of where we are too tired of doing lots of analysis, we can halt the session and talk about certification. So I'll give you exactly the guidelines of certification, like what how is it and all those things, and like I said, the assignment that I'll give you will give you a picture of what exactly questions come for certification. Okay, next, Krishna, Krishna, are you there? Would you like to say, just give a small introduction from your side? So Krishna is also not there. So Nageshwar.
Hello everyone.
Hi Nageshwar.
My name is Nageshwar Gandam Zetti. Hello ma'am. I did my master's in technology management from Southeast Madras State University, ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't have any previous experience in computer technologies. I have an electrical experience as I worked as electrical engineer in India.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, I don't have any knowledge on the Tableau. I'm looking forward to learn that this technology, this tool.
Okay.
That's all.
Okay.
Thank you, man.
Okay, thank you, Krishna. So not to worry, it's like it's a very easy tool and you'll not have much issue with how you go on. So let's see, because I would concentrate on taking the training from very scratch to how you do the data mapping and how you pull data from different sources. I don't think so you'll have any issues. Okay, next, can we head to Ramakrishnan?
Hello everyone, myself, I am Ramakrishna Parapati. I did my master's in technology management at Southeast Missouri State University. I too don't have any experience in computer technologies. I am also looking forward to learning.
You also looking for? I'm sorry, I just missed that part.
I'm also looking forward to learn this.
Okay. Okay guys, so it would be a nice session. You can just download Tableau public for the upcoming sessions, and we can start off with the session. And also I would request all of you to drop me your mail ID so that I can give you the data sets that would be required for the training. Okay guys, so it's 9:30. We end our sessions here, because after that, you know, once we start the session, it's never going to end dot on time. So every 5-10 minutes we would always extend. So okay, nice talking to you guys. Let's move ahead with Tableau, and let's make our data talk. Okay, let's meet up sometime. Thank you. Bye. Thank you.